Good morning, everyone. Imagine stepping into a mechanic's workshop at the start of the day, where the air is alive with energy and every moment counts. The morning unfolds with focus, determination, and a quiet satisfaction of seeing problems turn into solutions. It's a place where every action matters, and each small achievement builds a rhythm of a fulfilling day. Do you see these two metal pieces? Normally, you can't fix them firmly together without welding. But what if, like me, you don't have a welding machine here? Don't worry, because I have an idea. This idea lets you build a new homemade welding machine. Unlike before, we're trying a completely different approach. I'll guide you step by step, so even without a professional welder, you can do it. So let's get started. The first step is a short circuit method with a short piece of wire in my hand. Here's what we'll do. Connect one end of the wire to any terminal of the spark plug and the other end to the threaded body of the spark plug. This simple setup will help us move forward safely. Does anyone remember the short circuit method? Let's take a closer look. It's one of the simplest and oldest electrical techniques, creating a direct path for electricity between two points, bypassing resistance or other components. Historically, it was used in early experiments to test circuits quickly and safely, helping engineers understand how current flows and how energy can be directed. Today, it's perfect for temporary connections, testing, or homemade projects like our welding machine. Connecting one wire to the spark plug's terminal and the other to its body lets current flow in a controlled way, powering the arc for welding. Next, I have a single wire ready. We'll connect one end to the ground terminal of the spark plug and the other end to a crocodile clip. This clip will then attach to the positive side of the power source, completing the circuit and allowing current to flow. To secure the threaded body of the spark plug into the welding handle, I'll use double-sided tape. This simple method holds it firmly in place, making the setup stable and easy to handle. This is a piece of PVC pipe that I've already cut. It will serve as the body of our homemade welding handle, providing insulation and a safe grip while we work. Because I'm quite meticulous, I'll add a few drops of glue as well. This extra step ensures everything stays firmly in place and makes the setup more secure. With a single port connector, we'll use it as an intermediary to link the threaded end of the spark plug to our homemade welding tip. It makes the connection stable and easy to handle. This is the crocodile clip I mentioned earlier. We'll connect the remaining end of the wire to it. One more essential piece is a wire with two crocodile clips connecting to the negative side of the power source. It's still a familiar AA battery, just like in the previous video. We'll use the inner core to turn it into our homemade welding tip. If you're new here or don't remember the last video, make sure to pay close attention to the steps on the screen. However, this time the video is a bit different. I'll be creating a flux solution using the conductive core inside the battery and some toilet bowl cleaner. Yes, you heard that right. Let me explain scientifically. The core of the AA battery contains metals that conduct electricity well. When combined with certain chemical agents found in the toilet cleaner, it helps lower the resistance at the welding point, improves the flow of current, and stabilizes the arc essentially. This mixture acts as a flux, which is a substance used in welding to prevent oxidation and make the metal surfaces bond more efficiently. It's important to handle this carefully, as we're combining reactive materials. But when done correctly, it significantly enhances the performance of our homemade welder. To shape the battery core like a welding tip, we'll file down the sharp edges at both ends. One end will attach to the connector, and the other will be used for direct welding. This way, it mimics the structure of a real welding tip while staying safe and functional. Now, we're going to install our homemade welding tip into the connector. This step ensures a stable connection so the current can flow properly and the tip is ready for welding. Here, I'll use a small car battery to supply power for our homemade welding device. This battery provides enough current to create a stable arc while remaining portable and manageable for DIY use. No need to worry. The small flare is just from the battery core being slightly moist. It will settle quickly and work normally. So it's a success. Now, let's enjoy the testing process together with a few examples to see how well our homemade welder works.
Thank you.
And that wraps up our homemade welding project. I hope you enjoyed seeing how a simple AA battery, a few everyday materials, and a bit of creativity can come together to make a working DIY welding tool. It's amazing what you can accomplish when you experiment safely and think outside the box. Remember, every small experiment is a chance to learn something new. Don't be afraid to try your own project at home, but always prioritize safety first. Every success, no matter how small, builds your skills and confidence. If you enjoyed this video, please give a thumbs up, leave a comment sharing your thoughts, experiences, or questions, and subscribe to the channel for more creative DIY experiments. Your support really helps me keep making more projects like this. Stay safe while experimenting. Keep your curiosity alive. And remember that creativity and hands-on practice are the best ways to learn. Thanks so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.